The Archdiocese of Linggen-Dagupan joins Radio Veritas Simbayanan celebrating this Eucharist in thanksgiving for the 500th anniversary of the first Mass and the first baptisms in our islands. We are offering this Mass in Dagupan City. And the capital of Pangasinan is Lingayen. And all over Pangasinan, we have a town called Manawag, where the Virgin of the Rosary is venerated. I would like to look at the 500th anniversary of the first Mass and baptism in the Philippines from these three important towns of Pangasinan. The first is Lingayen. The Diocese of Lingayen was created in 1928. And Lingayen is related to the Tagalog word lingon. And lingon is look back. We look back at 1521. And we look back at Lingayen. And we believe that Lingayen is beautiful with its gulf, with its people. That is why you will keep on returning to it. But we cannot live our lives always looking back. Because if God intended us to keep on looking back, then God would have put our eyes at the back of our heads. But our eyes are in front of our faces. Because the Lord wants us to always look forward without sacrificing the past. The town of Lingayen invites us to look back because when we forget the lessons, the mistakes of the past, then we are bound to repeat those same mistakes into the future. The year 2021 is a year for recalling. It is a year for looking back. It is a year for returning to our roots. Our roots date back to Lingayen. And our roots date back to 1521, Lingayen. The second word to remember is Manawag. In Manawag, there is a basilica, and inside the basilica, there is the venerated centuries-old image of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. Manawag is related to the Tagalog word tawag. And tawag is call. Because in the town of Manawag, there is a voice that is heard. The voice that calls and says, come to me and I will bring you to Jesus, my son. That is what happened in 1521. We heard a voice that said, come to me, all you who are weary. Come to me, I will give you rest. Come to me, because in me there is life everlasting. Come to me, because in me there is joy. My dear brothers and sisters, Manawag with its Virgin invites us to follow Jesus. Our celebration of 1521 to 2021 would be meaningless if it is only a celebration of an event in history. The fact is, every day of those 500 years, every minute, every week, every year, every second of those 500 years, the voice is always heard, come, follow me. And the voice is always heard, come, follow me, and be holy like me. And our invitation for one another should be, come, let us walk together to the Lord. Let us be saints together. Lingayen invites us to look back. Manawag invites us to hear the voice that calls. Dagupan. Dagupan is related to the Pangasinan word, Nandaragupan. And Nandaragupan means assembly point. Assembly point is gathering point. It is a people gathered. But we are not only gathered for an ideology. We are not only gathered for a principle or a philosophy. We are gathered around a person, and that person is Jesus Christ. In a very real sense, my dear brothers and sisters, the Gupan cannot just be in the center of Pangasinan, because the whole world should be a Dagupan, because the whole world should be a meeting point where man and divine encounter each other. The church is that. Our faith is that. Dagupan, assembly point. We assemble in Dagupan for commerce, for politics, for culture, but also for faith. And our reason for gathering is not money, is not language, is not culture, is not food. Our reason for gathering together is the Lord. It is the Lord. Ecclesia, iglesia, means the people gathered together by the Lord. And our single reason for gathering together is the Lord. In Dagupan, in Lingayen, in Manawag, the message of the Lord rings clearly. Look back with gratitude. Answer the call of the voice and answer generously and courageously. And in Dagupan, the mission is clarified. The Lord came so that all may be one. The Lord came so that divisions may disappear. The Lord came so that wounds may be healed. The Lord came so that the whole humanity may be one in the Lord. Let us thank the Lord for the gift of memory which Lingayen offers us. Let us thank the Lord for the gift of a heart that listens, which Manawag reminds us of. Let us thank the Lord for the challenge of Dagupan to unite and to assemble under the banner of Christ. Amen.